Hey guys, welcome back to my channel. In our last video, we talked about naming binary ionic compounds. Today, we will talk about naming binary covalent compounds. Again, I am not an expert in the field of chemistry, but I will try to explain everything as simple and as easy to understand as possible based on how I understand it as a student. What is a binary covalent compound? It is a compound composed of two nonmetals. The less electronegative nonmetal comes first, followed by the more electronegative nonmetal. If you can remember in our past video about periodic trends, we said that the less electronegative element should be closer to the left and bottom of the periodic table. For example, if we have phosphorus and oxygen, phosphorus should come first since it is closer to the bottom and left side of the periodic table. The concept is pretty similar with the ionic compounds, but we do not determine the charges anymore and instead, we put prefixes before elements. Here are the prefixes we will be using. Mono is 1, di is 2, tri is 3, tetra is 4, penta is 5, hexa is 6, hepta is 7, octa is 8, nona is 9, and deca is 10. If you are given the chemical formula and asked to name the compound, you get the subscripts of the two atoms and put that as prefixes before each element. Take note that in the first element, we can put any prefix except for mono, and for the seventh element, we can put any prefix we need. After putting the prefixes, the last element gets the suffix -ide like what we do in ionic compounds. Let's have CO as an example. We know that if there is no subscript, it is automatically 1. Again, mono can't be used for the first element, so in CO, we put carbon as it is, and then the prefix mono for the oxygen with the suffix -ide to become carbon monoxide. Another example is N2O3. Nitrogen has 2, so it becomes dinitrogen, and oxygen has 3, so it becomes trioxygen, but we add the suffix -ide, so the whole compound is dinitrogen trioxide. Let's have a third example with CCl4. Carbon remains as it is, and then since chlorine has the subscript 4, we put the prefix tetra and then the suffix -ide to chlorine, so the whole compound becomes carbon tetrachloride. Now, if we are given the chemical name and asked to convert it to chemical formula, it is actually easier. You just write the two elements as chemical symbols and then have the prefixes as subscripts. For example, in carbon dioxide, we know that carbon is 1 and oxygen is 2 from the prefix di, so we write it like this. Another example is sulfur hexabromide. Sulfur has no prefix, so that is automatically 1, and bromine has the prefix hexa, so it is 6. We now use those values as subscripts, and the final formula should be like this. Our last example is tetraphosphorus decoxide. Don't get confused. This is just phosphorus and oxygen. Phosphorus has the prefix tetra, so we know that its subscript should be 4, and oxygen has the prefix deca, so its subscript should be 10. Now, we write the final formula like this. This is my second video about chemical nomenclature. The first one was naming binary ionic compounds. Be sure to check that out. And soon, we will cover naming polyatomic atoms and acids as well. Anyway, that's it for today. Thank you for watching. Leave your questions or suggestions in the comment section below. Like and subscribe for more videos. Thank you.